Welcome back to the 2019 ABS-CBN Ball, live on the red carpet. My name is Sarah Meyer, Tito Boy Abunda, of course, Bianca Gonzalez, and this time you're joined by beauty and fashion editor Kate Parra Santiago.
Hello,
and Sarah. Columnist, blogger, and writer Leah Puyat. We also have our host on location here at the fort. We're throwing now to Miss Gretchen Ho.
Sarah, we are here still at the artist holding area, the Shangri-La at the fort, and with me right now is a woman who stood out amongst the rest because of her red gown, and not just because of her red gown, because of her ageless beauty. Miss Isa Calzado.
You are too kind.
Isa, you know, I've been seeing you. You've been looking at the far end of the room. Are you looking at somebody?
Yes, I am, because my husband has been in line for quite some time as I am going around doing all these interviews. Ang dami nang dumaan. And he's been very patient. Sabi ko, don't just stay there so we don't lose our place.
And it is the first time of Ben.
Yes, it's his first time to be, you know, my date for the ball.
Who are you more nervous for? For Ben or for yourself?
Oh, he'll manage just fine. Ako naman ay wala lang nervous pagka ganito. You know, this is the time to have fun, enjoy. Kasama natin, ang mga kasama natin dito sa ABS-CBN. Tayo'y dapat maging masaya lamang. And of course, we're doing this for a very good cause. This is really for, you know, for kids to have access to education, which is important. So, it's a good day to celebrate, and it is the 65th year of ABS-CBN.
Speaking of which, Isa, you've been with the Kapamilya Network for 8 years. What are you grateful for in your experience?
Oh, wow, I am grateful for a lot of things. Actually, my very first film was with Star Cinema, even if I wasn't in ABS-CBN yet. And of course, I did Starting Over Again. I did a soap with Papa P. Hello, how can you not be grateful? Bakit? Check yun na malaking check. There's a lot of things that I'm grateful for. I was the host for Biggest Loser, where we first met. Yes, napakarami. And it just is a privilege. It's an honor to be a kapamilya.
Definitely, and I know we're not going to keep you any longer because you're worrying about Ben, so I'm turning it over back to the panel. That's it.
I love it. The beautiful Isa Calzado, oh classic, gosh. Wearing Raho Laurel, and I spoke with her stylist, Kat Cruz Villanueva. Sabi nila, for Isa, yun eh, classic yeah. Talaga beauty yes. Siya, no need to modernize, as is where is. As ganda lang ang puhon.
No, and when she speaks, when she talks, she has a certain sense of clarity, no?
Yes, yes. Oh, she has gravitas.
Gravitas is the word.
Yeah, especially as an actor. Wow, okay. Kanina, we saw Stephen Robles wearing a Frederick Burgess, and Jen Makapagal, of course, wearing a Philip Rodriguez, who's a friend of ours. But right now on screen, you are watching, I mean, the grand dame of Philippine movies, Mother Lily Monteverde and Rosel Monteverde. I love Mother. I really love Mother. Kanina po nakita natin si Lino Cayetano and
the Honorable Mayor siya dito.
The Honorable Mayor. We're in his house.
Okay. Kate, what would you want to say about some of the people, the clothes that who walked
actually,
the red carpet?
Actually, I was looking more at their faces, you know, especially Isa. Like, I was looking at her makeup. It was so simple. You didn't have to, you know, do something outrageous, really.
Grabe,
just red
no?
lips and then slick back hair and then that's it.
That's a gift. You yeah. know, when you said outrageous, you stared at me.
Didn't mean to.
No, actually, that is interesting. Yes. Kasi usually, di ba kapag Filipiniana, sanay tayo naka-updo. But today, we've been seeing
and the makeup tends
different.
To be demure. Mm-hmm. But there's a lot of bronzer and gold highlighter
right.
now,
mm-hmm. yeah.
which works so well with the Morena skin. And I think the gold gowns are really working.
Really,
fantastic
yeah.
on Morena
That's
skin.
That's true. We have the Star Creative family with
yes.
Olive Lamasa and Roxy Likigan, Miko Del Rosario,
Chris
and
Guzman
Chris
of Black
is there.
Sheep. Yes.
Right. These are the guys behind Star Creatives. Congratulations to Hello Love and
yes.
Goodbye. That makes now that is now the highest grossing Filipino movie
ever
of all time. Sabi nga kahit extra sana nag-walk in ako dun sa pelikula. That's ina.
Oh,
di ba? I mean,
that's a fantastic color. It's not an easy color.
What is it, Leah?
I think that's chartreuse.
Chartreuse.
Yes.
Okay.
Which is named after a liqueur, a French
oh.
liqueur.
Chartreuse.
Wow.
Okay.
Fun fact, courtesy
Christine
of
Reyes was in an Eric Beltran. We want to make that correction, okay?
Yeah, so Christine was wearing a parang may pearl embellishments.
Also
yeah.
the daughter.
Nerik Beltran.
Because they were wearing identical costumes there.
Yes, twinning.
Yes, twinning. That's how you call it. Yes, that's Rowena, right? Of the Ayala family, of the Ayala Mall family. Rowena is now what? You know, I've known Rowena when she was
studying. She's a Tamil Dan.
Yeah, she's
that's
a Tamil Dan, but her...
Yes.
Rank now is
she's now
one of the big bosses, right?
Yes, and she's in particular in charge of their development in China.
Wow.
So she's going back and forth China and Manila.
Thank you, Rowena. Welcome to and she was escorted by Jason De Las Alas. Again, who are we seeing on screen?
Tootsie.
Kate, would
this
you
is
want
Ms.
to comment
Tootsie
on
Tootsie? Angara.
Yes, it's Tootsie and
you know,
Sunny.
She's always regal, you know. In every event, she never fails. She's always on her best dressed list.
Yes,
and
absolutely.
It shows, you know.
One of the reasons why I really hate her.
Because it's not just regal.
You know?
She really, she is able to fuse this sort of classic timelessness with this spunk and pizzazz that she can really pull off. And it's one of, she has that classic, beautiful Filipina face.
Makes it so easy.
She's floating.
Yeah,
right, that's exactly.
She does.
Floating through the ball.
And you have Asani Angara, who is gorgeous. I'm sorry. There he is. I mean,
and I think this is different for her because every sauna, of course, she dresses up in a traditional terno. Usually, she wears Rahul Aurel.
And
now
one year she wore her prom dress.
Oh, really?
Yes, one year because her mom was best friends with Pitoy Moreno. So as a teenager, she had a Pitoy Moreno prom dress.
That was a brilliant idea.
So one sauna, she wore her prom dress.
I love stories like that.
She's in her prom dress. Can we focus on that?
Now you understand why I don't necessarily like, you know, no, I love Tootsie. I love Tootsie. There.
Andre's Lauren.
Of course. Our beloved.
Lisa Joggy.
And Laurenti Joggy. He is our go-to person in ABS-CBN. Talagang mababang aking bosses because every time I see Lauren, I have a problem to solve. And he always solves it for us.
But he wears a barong very well.
He does. Yes.
He
does.
Can wear a barong every day.
Right.
Like that.
Actually, barong suit, kahit ano, kayang-kaya talaga ni Director.
Actually, even foreigners look good in barong.
I agree.
That's true.
I totally agree.
I don't
agree.
Know why, but foreigners look good in barong.
There's something
about
the barong.
I love the barong. My husband, when he got married, barong siya.
Yeah.
My husband, iba yung, di ba? Iba yung dating.
No, because you are a real man if you can wear embroidery.
Yes.
And
Tama.
That's a sheer garment. So you're a real man.
It's so true. A lot of the focus, I think, is always about the clothes. But like, I really want to talk also about the face, how people are put together, because it does complete the look. Kata, as a beauty editor.
Okay, I have to go back to Miss Tootsie.
Okay.
Her skin was glowing. We were predicting that glowing skin would be a big trend. You know, all these celebrities, they already have good skin, but the makeup artists make sure to showcase the skin, you know, using highlighters. All of them have a skincare routine before putting makeup on, so that's one thing we should watch out for.
I'm actually a fan of Tootsie, but I just love Sunny Angara. I wanted to walk out and I saw her.
Sunny Angara, unfortunately, had no highlighter or bronzer.
like a Senate walkout,
yeah,
right?
I know.
Like a Senate walkout, an ABS ball walkout.
Just because Tootsie Angara is just so gorgeous. We saw Sylvia Sanchez and Art Ataide earlier, the lovely Sylvia Sanchez. You know, we're actually talking because I have all the reasons to hate Tootsie Angara because I love Sunny Angara, okay? Isn't she just the most beautiful? Look at her. Tootsie Angara is wearing a Rahul Aurel, okay? So there, I was talking earlier about Art Ataide and Sylvia Sanchez.
Okay, can we talk about women wearing a barong?
Can you please?
Because I love this look. You know, we talk about gender fluidity a lot in this generation, and I think that we have been paying homage to that in our culture when women rock the barong, because it's like you're saying, embroidery is feminine. It's a delicate material, a delicate fabric. You can pair it with a skirt and just make it an entire look to itself.
No, but
it's a go-to of a lot of modern women. Yeah,
and I
to
love
wear
it.
The barong.
It has so much. It exudes so much strength. But you know, remember when Chanel first Coco deconstructed the suit. You know, and
she was obsessed with the British.
I know.
She had a British lover.
Right.
So
two of them.
Yeah,
best friends.
At the same time.
So she was obsessed with the British. There you go. There again. Kita Sylvia Sanchez.
Right.
Hi, how nice.
No, but what I like about it is you mentioned the word fluid and the rules. When you try to break the rules, pero nadadala, I'm fine with it. What are the trends now, Kate? I mean, in terms in terms of clothing.
Of our theme for tonight, you know, it's not just about the terno, although it's one of the biggest trends. There's the Maria Clara, and then the Philippine textiles is also a big thing, you know.
Right.
A lot of the designers work with local communities, so that's one conversation we should always have.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because they're able to help all these women who work in the provinces and put them in the limelight. So
because embroidery is a dying art.
Craft.
We should be able to support.
So we should support our embroiderers, our weavers.
Our weavers as well.
No, but we also have to be very careful about our indigenous weavers. We were talking about earlier that to show respect, you have to collaborate very closely with the weavers because there are those. No, there are those that are used for weddings. There are used
funerals.
There are those that are used for funerals.
Yeah. Only the high priests can wear them.
Right.
Or only the tribal chieftains.
Paggalang natin yun.
We have to be very aware. Cultural appropriation is a big issue now, and we just have to be sensitive.
Right.
Yeah. Earlier, Bianca, we saw Melissa Jimenez,
Sophie Reyes,
and Jillian Vicente.
All with their very youthful, with a bit of sexy take on modern Filipiniana.
Naiingit ako sa mga bagets na ito. They're just so vibrant. They're just so, di ba? Beautiful. And of course, again, on your screen, we have Iza.
Yeah, so you were talking about skin. Skin, again, Iza is displaying the flawless skin. And, but the hair, I think she's the first we see with a
slick
hair look.
And Ben is just so gorgeous.
First time niya to walk the red carpet.
I'm speechless. I'm just staring at these two gorgeous beings. And they're such, like, and you really...
Like they're new Barbie and Ken.
Right.
And I want to say why.
They could be the Filipino Barbie and Ken.
They're so genuine and such beautiful people. And that is always the best accessory that you can have on these red carpets.
No, I want to repeat that. Because, you know, clothes are clothes. But, you know, who are you inside, I think, matters the most.
Definitely.
Ang mabuting tao kasi nitong dalawa. When you talk about Ben and Iza, they're fantastic people inside and out. There they go. You can't be so beautiful if you're not beautiful inside, I think.
I agree.
Diba? There, okay, so who do we have?
I think Ben had to bring out his wedding smile again. Yung smile kada stop.
He's shy, you know?
Yeah, he's very shy. So to see him totally smiling.
But obviously smitten.
Yes.
Obviously smitten.
They are still in their honeymoon phase.
You know, they weren't married yet.
How would you not be with a wife?
Right. Yeah, they're obviously
they weren't
still
married yet, and I was
madly
trying to flirt with Ben. It didn't work.
Wow.
No, I was.
He passed the test.
Come on, guys. This is a red carpet. Okay, who are we seeing now?
We are looking at R.A. Lewis.
Okay. And what can you say about the clothes? I mean, let's start with... they are R.A. Lewis.
Ayana Wagoner and Kenru Garcia.
Wow, I mean, you know, and this girl.
Oh, Rampa. All right.
So, new batch of Star Circle members. Star Magic.
You know, every time I see these young girls and boys, I always remember that there is hope in the industry. Because for people like us who started in the business 2 years ago, 2 years ago.
2 years ago. When you were X years old.
No, but somehow, diba, you remember that, you know, this is going to go on for the rest of the world, you know, in a long, long time.
Oh, wow. Ayana, the Call Me Tita stars, Cherry Pie Pingache, Melly Dizon, with the one
JC Buendia,
Marlon Rivera.
Cherry Pie's Terno.
No, but I love that stance again. There they go again, diba? The great actors.
Mylene is the first one we've seen doing print. Like a printed version of
I love the daring, diba?
Yes, they're loving it. They're owning it.
I love that word, diba? They're owning it. That's Mylene. Look at Mylene's face.
I really want to talk. Mylene Dizon is one of the most beautiful Filipina faces
for
me. She really embodies everything that I love about the confluence of influences of races that make up the Filipino, no?
You know, I totally agree with you. One time, just before an interview, I told her, "You to me are the most beautiful Filipina right now." You know, some time ago, Mylene Dizon. Really beautiful.
And I think that what these two women have in common, which I also think is a component of style, is intelligence.
That's right.
They are just radiating intelligence.
So okay, I'm talking about intelligence.
And that's really part of their style, I think.
That's part of style.
It definitely is.
Okay, that was Cherry Pie, Kanina, Mylene, cast members of Call Me Tita. Mylene was wearing?
Neric Beltran. Yes, Call Me Tita, of course, another groundbreaking project for ABS-CBN. This is the first time they have an I Want series that they launched simultaneously on the main network.
I wanted to be part of it.
Trended immediately.
and on TV.
Ganun. I wanted to be part of it.
Super interesting.
What's your role, Tito Boy, kung gano'n?
Call me Tito.
Totoo din naman.
Okay, Agot is wearing a JC. Look at her.
Beautiful.
Diba?
It's kahit luminous.
Dun, yeah, she's I love that luminous word. Luminous. Okay? And then...
Call me Tito.
Hi, Ben. Call me Tito. Okay.
This is a love fest. There's a love fest.
Yeah, earlier on screen, you were able to see Direk Andoy Ranay. You were able to see
where?
Agot Isidro wearing JC Buendia. Earlier on screen, earlier. Okay. Yeah. Tito Boy. So we gotta keep up. JC
Agot,
Santos wearing Boy Kastner Santos.
Santos.
Earlier.
Okay.
Yes.
There we go. Who is this right now?
This is a different take on the Barong Tagalog,
obviously. A different take on the Barong Tagalog,
yeah,
yes.
Kind of metallic.
His name is Mark Rivera.
Okay.
Hi, Mark. You have to forgive us. Hi, Mark. You better say hi, Tito Boy. Okay. No, but these are the boys 3, 4, 5 years from now would be winning awards, would be
correct,
breaking box office records, and we are just so excited. Hi. Hi, Pai. Hi, Marlon. Hi, hi.
It really is a love fest here. No, it's like, it's like one
it
massive
is
reunion.
Now, right now, we have three young hopefuls again. What are they thinking? We're Bel Mariano.
Again, okay, modern takes on the Barong some made into a like a suit silhouette, right?
Okay. Can you see from there,
yes,
Kate?
It's more severe. Because it's the traditional Barong is actually a softer cut.
Okay. No, but you have to get us the names, to be fair. We have to know Bel
Mariano.
Mariano. Kachi Mejia. I'm sorry?
Kachi Mejias.
Kachi Mejias. Again, there, very good-looking young boys and girls.
I'm with a very beautiful Mylene Deason. Hi, Mylene. Tito Boy, Bianca and Sarah in the panel, we're talking about your lovely gown. Can you tell us about it? Kasi sa likod may detail pa. Can you show it to us?
Actually, this whole thing was printed. Printed yung aking tela. Hindi yan gawa na nung binili. We've got the Filipino flowers and the Maya bird. And this gown was made by Nerick Beltran.
You know, Mylene, I'm so also excited because your series, Call Me Tita, is just so amazing. It's so relatable. It talks about, you know, midlife crisis, relationships, lahat na. And you're such a cool tita there.
Of course. Yeah, of course, nakakate, of course. Everybody's got a different role. And we try to represent the different titas. Although there's plenty, and yeah, I know we can't represent all of them, but as much as we can, we try to represent, you know, a little bit of all the titas out there. And the titas nowadays, because we're cool, we're different, we're not like losyang already. You know, we try to make most of what we have, our time and our lives.
And I love it kasi demure ka doon, di ba? Yun na nga, nanibago. Mylene, have a great night. Let's have fun later. But for now, Sarah, Bianca, and Tito Boy, back to you guys.
Thank you, Gretchen. Thank you, Gretchen. Thank you, Mylene. God.
Yes, I'd just like to read something we saw Sir Ernie Lopez earlier with Michelle Arville walking the red carpet.
Okay.
Sir Ernie Lopez, president of Creative Programs Inc., which is the cable and publishing business. Yes.
Everyone's boss.
Of ABS-CBN. will continue the legacy of his sister, of course.
Our beloved.
The great Gina Lopez as the host of her show, G-Diary. So it's still in the family.
Right.
And he's so energetic, so
absolutely
vibrant,
yes,
perfect person too.
And life is one big adventure for him.
G-Diaries. And of course, his date, Michelle Arville.
And very kind.
Michelle is wearing Vanya Rumoff. Vanya, who is also doing a number of guns.
Okay, Kanina, we saw Karen Davila. I mean, and then we're seeing now Tita Baby Arenas and Rachel Arenas. And we would like to bring you back to Gretchen Folido. And we will... Gretchen?
I'm with the other Tita, Tita Cherry Pie Picache. Hi, Tita Cherry Pie.
Hi, good evening, Gretchen. I embrace it, yes.
Embrace me.
Tita Cherry Pie.
You know, we were talking about how relatable the series is and parang enjoy na enjoy ka talaga doing it.
Yeah, I know. I mean, you know, to begin with, I'm working with all my friends in and out of the industry. And with the rest of the Titas, it felt like we weren't working at all. So, ganon. So, ang saya-saya talaga.
But you know, everybody was asking, yung dun sa daring scene yun ni Mark, was that very difficult to shoot? Nag-enjoy ka?
Both of All of the above. No. You know, it was out of my comfort zone. But, you know, I was telling myself, I'm almost 50. When else should I do it? Yes. And it's a very different role for me. So, yeah. So,
at sinasabi nila, life begins when you're a tita.
Yes, it does. Very liberating. You should celebrate life. Next year, I'll be turning 50 and I'm so proud of it.
You don't look it. You're aging gracefully, Cherry Pie. Okay, let's have fun tonight.
Yes, we will rock and roll.
Okay, and now let's go to Gretchen Ho.
Thank you so much, Gretchen. It's a love fest indeed tonight. And here with me, who demonstrates just that, is Regine Velasquez Alcacin, of course. Her lover boy, Augie Alcacin. Oh, diba? You'll be performing tonight, I believe. What should we expect? Are you going to be singing together?
We are singing with other artists. Madami kami, so. And parang ano to eh, parang tribute, 65 years ni ABS-CBN plus for Bantay Bata. So, may mga ganun.
All right. Speaking of performing, you recently had the chance to do just that in the Bay Area for ASAP Natin To. How was that experience like?
It was wonderful kasi first time kong mag-perform na kapamilya na ako.
Galing-galing so, niya kasi, di ba?
Masaya siya. Tapos meron pang Rome.
What?
Rome.
When is that?
November 16, 2019. Abangan niyo po kami dyan sa Europa. ASAP will be there in Rome.
Yes.
Okay, you've been with the Kapamilya for almost a year and you also very recently. What has been the highlight of your stay with the Kapamilya Network so far?
Alam mo ko anong highlight ng Kapamilya stay ko? Yung pagdating ng asawa ko. Oh! Oh!
I told you it was a love fest over here.
Ako yung highlight ko yata ito eh. Ito ngayong gabi, oo.
Doing the ABS-CBN ball, dressing up.
Kasi it's officially my first time.
Yes.
My first time talaga.
How did you prepare for your first ABS-CBN ball?
Hindi nga ako masyado nakapag-prepare. Parang natulog ako. Kasi I've been shooting eh. So, ayun lang.
What do you hope to do tonight?
I'm singing, so I hope I'd be able to sing properly. And I wanna eat.
Yes, that is the most fun part, and you should not skip on that. Thank you so much, Augie and Regine. We're definitely looking forward to your performance later here tonight. And welcome. Welcome to your first ABS-CBN ball. Turning it over back to the panel.
Ang ganda ni Regina.
Thank you, Gretchen and Gretchen. Regine, right. The beautiful Regine wearing Carrie Santiago, of course, and Augie wearing Randy Ortiz. And I just want to share Hi, Karen!
And Gary V was wearing a Not Manilag. We're waving now to Karen Davila.
Ang dami nangyayari dito, mga kapamilya. But yeah, Regine said she looked tired because she feels tired but looks amazing because she's shooting. And that's actually her first ever indie film, which is a Cinemon original.
That's right.
She said yes to finally shooting one. So many people are excited about that.
And off-cam, I mean just behind the cam, Karen Davila is greeting everybody. That's Karen, a dear friend of ours. And she's not part of Call Me Tita. Karen, are you part of the film Call Me Tita? Are you? No, she's not. She's not.
Lulu Tangan.
She's wearing a Lulu Tangan. One of the nicest girls in, show business and the news business, Miss Karen
Davila. She
really
wants the designer to be credited.
Yes,
she,
that's right.
She really wants her dress Lulu to be acknowledged. Yeah.
We got it. We got a message, Karen.
Okay, so before we cut to commercial, we have Ronaldo Valdez and Gloria Diaz on camp. Isabel Dazo also earlier. Lian Cate, favorite so far in the batch that you just
I'd
saw?
I'd have to say Miss Tootsie and Mylene.
Okay.
Yeah. Ikaw, Lia.
I have to agree with Mylene. That she really and I
thank
can see
you.
I can see the joy she has because that's a big part of it. Like, you know, she's twirling her train.
Right.
She's really loving the dress, which is a big part of just being stylish. She's loving what you're wearing.
Okay,
and
right.
Having fun, right?
Right now we
having fun. Having fun.
We have of course the one and only Gloria Diaz. Have you seen
our
Gloria?
Our country's first Miss Universe.
1969. Yes, and she was with Ronaldo Valdez.
They're playing husband and wife.
That's right.
In Los Bastardos,
which you are, still on air. They are on their last 2 weeks, mga kaibigan. Yeah. So okay, we will be seeing more stars on the red carpet, but stay there because we will be right back.